Democrats take control of the House and vow to push for passage of the Equality Act. That bill would explicitly add sexual orientation and gender identity to the list protected by civil rights law. Let's take a look at this bill with Monica Burke, research assistant at the Heritage Foundation. Monica, welcome.
Thank you for having me, Jason.
So this bill covers discrimination in broad areas of life, including employment, education, housing. How would this passage of this bill impact the country?
Yes, so this bill would have a sweeping impact on federal anti-discrimination law. What it could potentially mean is it could potentially mean a nationwide preferred pronoun policy. It could potentially mean...
pronoun policy?
Yes, so we've seen conflicts where people are being compelled by the government to use the preferred pronouns according to someone's preferred or self-identified gender identity against what their biological sex is. So we've already seen there was, for example, a teacher in Virginia who was fired not even for using the biological pronouns of someone who wanted to use their preferred pronouns, but simply from abstaining from using pronouns altogether. So potentially this bill could implement a policy like that that would force people to use preferred pronouns against their conscience from the national level.
So the supporters of this law say, though, it's going to stop discrimination. What would you say to them?
We would say that this act simply doesn't deliver on its name. The Equality Act ultimately perpetuates inequality by forcing people to violate their consciences, by putting people in compromising positions that violate their privacy rights and their safety. So this bill could also impose a nationwide bathroom bill, which would open up sex-specific facilities to people of the opposite biological sex, which obviously poses extreme concerns for women and children's safety. And then this bill, one other thing that it could do is impose a national health care mandate. So it could force doctors, nurses, hospitals, and insurers to pay for and provide drastic sex change surgeries and hormone treatments. So this bill is, it would have sweeping implications for average Americans.
That last point about impacting hospitals, would that possibly force Catholic hospitals? Would they try to force Catholic hospitals to provide some of these treatments then?
Yes, so unfortunately that's already happening. There are two lawsuits where Catholic hospitals have been sued for failing to provide sex change surgeries. And so we should expect to see more of these conflicts of conscience, more of these lawsuits, should the Equality Act become law.
So you'd mentioned the schools and the bathroom bill. How would this impact schools across the country as well?
It would have a devastating impact on schools. So we've already seen a case out of Georgia where a five-year-old kindergarten student was assaulted by a male classmate in her bathroom. And basically when her mother went to the school and said, hey, I would like to keep this boy out of the female-only spaces, what the school said was, according to our policy, this student is allowed access to the facilities of the gender that he identifies with. So under a national policy like the Equality Act, we could expect to see more conflicts like that one.
Speaker Pelosi yesterday in her remarks on the floor after taking the gavel said she promised to take this up for a vote. It would likely then fail in the Senate because in the Senate it would need 60 votes, which is almost impossible with all the conservatives in the Senate. But we're definitely monitoring this. Thank you so much for joining us. Monica Burke from the Heritage Foundation. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.